they did for our Bridges unit, which is one of our IB units in first grade. And they chose this project. They voted to share this project with you. And I know that you'll be really good listeners. And if you have questions or comments that you would like to share, you could please save those until the very end and we'll get all of your questions.
Today we are going to show you a project that we did in our class. In first grade, we learned about bridges. We had a big question to investigate. The question was, why is a suspension bridge stronger than a beam bridge? Why is a suspension bridge stronger than a beam bridge?
That's not able to know.
A beam bridge consists of a horizontal beam supported by two beams. And now Ava is drawing a beam. So we have that needs to have the
suspenders, which are the yarn pieces, that those are large bridge load.
It's not funny.
How many books did the bee bridge hold? Antonio's?
Zero.
Isha.
Here's why the suspension bridge can support the books. The cardboard and the stack of books pull on the strings. The strings pull on the ropes. The ropes push down on the chairs. So all the way up the bridge. And the string of books is on the chair. And the rope is also pulling on. Okay, all the pushing is called tension. All the pounding is called tension, and all the pushing is called tension. What happens if you don't pull as hard on the ropes?
Tension, compression.
Isha, could you repeat that question one more time? What happens if you don't pull as tightly on the rope? So Julia and Elena are not going to pull on the ropes. We'll see what happens.